Ortac Resources has switched focus away from its Eastern European gold project in Slovakia towards a new partnership on a Zambian copper asset. Today it's told investors it is pleased with the latest trenching samples from its Zambian associate, the copper explorer Zamsort. Vassilios Carellas is the Ortac Resources chief executive. He joins me now. So, Vassilios, what do the trench results from the Kalaba Open Pit reveal?
Well, they obviously reveal that the material that's imminently going to be mined is actually of a grade which most heap leach copper acid leach operations in the world today would make a lot of money on. So, from that point of view, it sort of ties in with a lot of the DD work that we've done on the historical material that has been mined and processed. So it's given us comfort that the information, the data that we've been given is more or less accurate.
So let me get this straight. High grade, profitable, and mining is imminent. How imminent?
Well, the deposit itself has been mined intermittently for the last 10 years, so it has been in production. The only difference is that they now are actually constructing an acid leach plant on site, and so this is the first time that this particular project has had a plant on site. In the past, the material has been rudimentally upgraded on site and shipped off site for further processing.
So there were 9 trenches, and 3 of those trenches yielded these results that are making you so pleased.
That's right. I mean, and also, what should be noted is the cobalt grades as well. Those are pretty significant as well, if not just as valuable as the copper, which is a real positive as far as the project itself is concerned. So it's not just the copper, it's the cobalt as well.
Okay, so bearing in mind you've got 2 commodities there, so therefore what does the follow-up program or the next stage of exploration entail?
Well, obviously, initially it would be around the existing mining operation, and that's something that is being planned at the moment. But then, you also have the larger prospecting license area, which in its own right has got all the hallmarkings of hosting quite a significant project or deposits in that license area.
So if my research is accurate, you have invested $1.2 million in Zamsort so far. How strong is that relationship? Because it's still early days.
It is, and that's something that's been worked on. And apart from us having invested, there's another party that has invested, and it looks to be another potential other party coming in November. So, the asset is such that the people that have invested or the groups that have invested after us have invested at a premium to what we've gone in, and that just gives you an indication of the significance of this particular project. I mean, it is one that everyone is looking at the moment, particularly in that part of the copper belt.
Okay, so that's encouraging indeed, because it's not just you that Zamsort are reliant on. I'm wondering if you and your partners will need to invest more, and if so, how you all intend to do this.
Well, as I said, there is potentially another party coming to the table in the next month or two. And again, depending on how Zamsort approaches the development of this asset, initially they were looking to get this hydroxide cake plant operational, and that would spin off sufficient capital initially to do some of the initial work. However, if they do want to proceed a little bit more aggressively, then potentially they may look for additional funding. But at this point in time, they are focused on getting this hydroxide cake plant operational and using that revenue generated from that on the rest of the license area.
Okay, finally, I'm going to bring this conversation around 360 degrees. Any regrets at all about switching focus from Slovakia?
Well, we haven't really switched focus from Slovakia. We've still got the Slovak asset and it's our flagship asset. It's just that this opportunity came and it was one with near-term production. So we are still in the background working, you know, on the Slovak asset, but it's something that we've got a couple ideas that we're pushing forward. But as far as the focus is concerned, yes, it is in Africa, but the main asset in the company at the moment is still that resource. I mean, you've got to remember that's over 1.3 million ounce resource with just under a million ounces in reserves. And even at today's gold prices, that project would still work, in theory. So it is still a very good asset.
Vassilios Carellas, Chief Executive of Ortac Resources, thank you very much for joining us today.
Great, thank you.